When I looked at your record, you talk about big government and how opposed you are to it, but you seem to have a different attitude about your own congressional district. For example, the Congress decided to send billions of dollars to victims of Hurricane Katrina. Guess how Ron Paul voted? Quote, is bailing out our people that chose to live on the coastline a proper function of the federal government, he asked, and you said no. And yet this, Paul's current district, which includes Galveston and reaches into the Brazoria County, draws a substantial amount of federal flood insurance payments for your own congressional district. This is the Houston Chronicle. Representative Ron Paul has long crusaded against a big central government, but he also represented a congressional district that's consistently among the top in Texas in its reliance on dollars from Washington. In the first 9 months of the federal government's fiscal 2006 fiscal year, it received more than $4 billion. And they report, the Wall Street Journal, 65 earmarked targeted projects, $400 million, that you have put into congressional bills for your district, which leads us to the Congressional Quarterly, the earmarked dossier of Dr. No. There isn't much that Dr. Ron Paul thinks the federal government should do. Apparently, though, earmarks for his district are okay. Yes. Paul is the sponsor of no fewer than 10 earmarks in water resources bill, all benefiting his district. The Gulf Intercoastal Waterway, $32 million. The sunken ship you want to remove from Freeport Harbor. The Bayou Navigation Channel. They talk about $8 million for shrimp fishermen. Why would you load up?
You got it completely wrong. I've never voted for an earmark in my life.
No, but you put them in the bill.
I put them in because I represent people who are asking for some of their money back. But it doesn't cut any spending to vote against the earmark. And the Congress has the responsibility to spend the money. Why leave the money in the executive branch and let them spend the money?
That's like saying you voted for it before you voted against it.
Nah, come on, Tim. That has nothing to do with that.
You put it in the bill and get the headlines.
No, I make the request. They're not in the bill.
Then you know it's going to pass Congress, and so you don't refuse the money.
Well, no, of course not. It's like taking a tax credit. If you have a tax credit, I'm against the tax system, but I take all my tax credits.
But if you were
I want to get their money back for the
philosophy,
people.
You would say, no pork spending.
No, that's not it. They steal our money. That's like saying that people shouldn't take Social Security money. I don't advocate that.
All right, let me
I try to save the system, make the system work.
Let me ask you
this.
But
now I think you have it all mixed up.
Well,
now you're confused.
It's all facts.
You're confused.
This is the Wall Street Journal. You load up the bills with special projects.
No, you don't.
You do. You deny that you have.
How many of them ever got passed? But the whole point is we have a right and an obligation.
They pass. You vote against them, but you take the money.
No, you don't quite understand.
Okay.
They take our money from us, and the Congress has the authority to appropriate, not the executive branch. And I'm saying that I represent my people. They have the request. It's like taking a tax credit, and I put it in. The whole process is corrupt.
All right, let me ask you that.
I vote against everything.
But
I vote against it, so I don't endorse the system.
But when it passes, overwhelmingly, you take the money back home.
I don't take it. That's the system. I'm trying to change that system. To turn it around and say I'm supporting the system, I find it rather ironic and
entertaining. Well, when you stop taking earmarks or putting earmarks in the spending bills, then I think you'll be consistent. Let me ask you about this. Term limits. You ran on term limits. I think we should have term limits for our elected leaders. You've been in Congress 18 years.
But I never ran on voluntary term limits. There's a big difference. I didn't sign a pledge for a voluntary term limit. Matter of fact, some of the best people that I worked with who were the most principled came in on voluntary term limits. Some of them broke their promises and some didn't, and they were very good people. So some of the good people left. And it's true, I didn't run on that, Tim. You're wrong on that. I support term limits. You know, we had 16 votes one time on term limits, and I voted yes for them. But voluntary term limits is a lot different than compulsory term limits. Well, it's good to have a turnover, but that isn't a solution either. It's the philosophy of government that counts.
But if you believe in the philosophy of term limits, why wouldn't you voluntarily
one of those things that's not. I mean, you don't see that. I'm campaigning on that. I mean, I don't think it's a solution. Oh. Philosophy is the solution. What the role of government ought to be. So if you have a turnover and the same people come in and they believe in big government, nothing good is going to come of it.
Let me ask you about immigration, because that's a big issue here. And there has been a profound change in your thinking on that. Back when you ran for president in 1988, libertarian, you said, quote, as in our country's first 150 years, there shouldn't be any immigration policy at all. We should welcome everyone who wants to come here and work. You've changed your view.
And during that campaign, I remember I got into trouble with the libertarians because I said there may well be a time when immigration is like an invasion and we have to treat it differently. And I think in one sense, with the welfare state out of control, see, my approach to immigration is somewhat different than the others. Mine is you deal with it economically. We're in worse shape now because we subsidize immigration. We give food stamps, Social Security, free medical care, free education, and amnesty. So you subsidize and you have a mess. Our hospitals are being closed. Conditions have changed. And I think that we should have, and 9/11 has occurred. Why shouldn't we be looking at people coming in? So there's this means that we should look at immigration differently. It's an economic issue more than anything. If our economy was in good health, Believe me, I don't think it'd be an immigration problem. We'd be looking for workers and we would be very generous.
You say you're a strict constructionist of the Constitution, and yet you want to amend the Constitution to say that children born here should not automatically be U.S. citizens.
Well, amending the Constitution is constitutional. What's a contradiction there?
So have the Constitution as written, you want to amend?
Well, that's constitutional to do it. Besides, it was the 14th Amendment. It wasn't the original Constitution. And there's a confusion on the interpretation. In the early years, it was never interpreted that way. And it's still confusing because people, individuals are supposed to have birthright citizenship if they're under the jurisdiction of the government. And somebody who illegally comes in this country as a drug dealer, is he under the jurisdiction and their children deserve citizenship? I think it's awfully confusing. And I, matter of fact, I have a bill to change that as well as a constitutional amendment to clarify it.
Let me ask you about drugs and go back again to your 1988 campaign and see where you stand today. All drugs should be decriminalized. Drugs should be distributed by any adult to other adults. There should be no controls or production, supply, or purchase for adults. Is that still your position?
Yeah, it's sort of like alcohol. Alcohol is a deadly drug, kills more people than anything else. And today, the absurdity on this war on drugs, Tim, has just been horrible. We now, the federal government, takes over and overrules state